Okay, now here's a problem that deals with several different properties of limits and kind of makes us think about how those properties work. So they give us all of these limits as x approaches 9. And basically what we have is an f of x function and a g of x function. So they tell us what those limits are. And they're telling us that that limit is negative 5 here and negative 3 here. So we want to know what's f of x plus the limit of f of x plus g of x squared. Well, all we need to know then is what f of x equals, which is a negative 5, plus what g of x equals, which is negative 3. And then we're going to square all of that. And so negative 5 minus 3 is negative 8 squared is 64. And it really is just that easy. Okay, here we've got a problem where we're looking at a piecewise function and they want to know what the limits are as we approach a specific value. And on this problem, they give us that value to be 1. So we're really interested in what goes on at 1. And in order to determine whether or not we have a limit, remember, when you have a limit of something, if I have some graph, and this might be how that graph looks, if I'm interested at 1, as long as I approach the same y-coordinate from both sides, I have a limit. And if we're interested at 1, then what we can do is substitute a 1 in for all the x's. So we can put a 1 in right here, we can put a 1 in right here, and as long as we approach the same value all the way around from both sides, we will have a limit. So when we look at a, the limit as we approach d from the left, that's going to be the negative 6x plus 13. Well, we can substitute 1 in here because that's what we're interested in. And when I do that, I get 7. So I'd have negative 6 plus 13, which is 7. For part B, that's when we approach from the right. Well, that's the bottom guy. So I'm going to have negative 3x plus 1. That's when we approach from the right. We use that equation. Well, just substitute a 1 in. Negative 3x times 1 plus 1. So that's negative 3 plus 1, which is negative 2. So there's that limit. And then C, the limit as we approach D. Well, we don't approach a specific point, so the limit does not exist. Okay, what we're going to look at with this problem is the sandwich theorem, and they give us the sandwich. They tell us what the inequality should look like. They tell us how it's going to work. We just need to show that it's going to be true. And to do this, all we're going to do is we're going to separate this guy out and understand that with sandwich theorem, if this goes to one place and this goes to the same place, then the guy in the middle here has to also go to that same spot. So what we're interested in is the value that we approach when x gets close to 0. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at the limit as x approaches 0 of 1 minus x squared over 2. And we're going to look at the limit as x approaches 0 of 1. And we want to know what both of these guys equal. And if they equal the same exact thing, then we know that we're going to have a limit. So when I plug 0 into this first equation, I get 1. And the limit of a constant is just a constant. So by the sandwich theorem, since my two limits of these two guys in red, since it goes to the exact same place, then the limit as x approaches 0 of sine x over x also goes to the same place. And that really is all that the Sandwich Theorem is doing.